Dashboards help you monitor events or activities by providing key insights and analysis on one or more tabs or screens. In this video, you will see how to use a template to accelerate your design and build, how to create a multi-tab dashboard, how to add and change visualizations, how filters can be used to limit data and focus attention, how to sort data in visualizations, and how to add text to a dashboard. These are the two tabs that will be created in the dashboard during this video. The coffee sales and marketing data module is used in this video. It can be found in the samples data. I did some data preparation before recording this video. Split was used to create sales hour from time, and sales month and sales day were split from date. If you're not familiar how to use Split, you can watch the video How to Create a Data Module from an uploaded file to learn more. I changed the aggregation rule for total goal in sales targets from average to total. To create the dashboard, click Present Data, then Dashboard. The two large and six small template will be used in this video. The coffee sales and marketing data module is the data source. Templates contain predefined designs and grid lines for easy arrangement and alignment of visualizations. If you're not familiar with the data being used, you can use the data tray to inspect it. All the tables in the data module appear, and I can scroll through the data as well as selecting each table and seeing the data. In my scenario, I know I want to focus my analysis on April sales. Because I can open the data module, I also know that the dates table is related to the sales receipt table. To apply a filter to focus my data just on April, I can select the member and drop it up in this tab filter area. Now when I use anything from a table that has a relationship to the dates table, it will only return April data. I want to start by comparing actual sales to target sales. The KPI visualization is well suited for this. Sales is dropped in the base value slot, and total goal is dropped in the target value. My sales amount has been filtered by the filter for April that I had created, but total goal is across all time periods because it's not attached to the dates table. To apply a filter to total goal, I can expand the sales month, pick up the member, and drop it as a local filter. Now I can see my KPI is showing me just April sales and April total goal. To look at store performance, sales and store address is dropped on the canvas. A column chart has been picked by Cognos Analytics. I pick up total goal and drop it in the target slot. Now again, remember, target sales is not attached to date, so it's not being filtered. To focus the target goal just on April, I'm going to pick up the April sales month member and drop it on the filter tab. So now this will be applied across any visualization on my tab. I can also resize then my visualization to fit into the template size. To understand how sales vary day to day, a line chart is used. Sales day is dropped in the x-axis, and sales is dropped in the y-axis. I can resize the line chart to fit the space in the template, and just to expand it. To see if there are consecutive days of poor sales, an average line can be plotted by turning on insights. To get insight into sales by day of the week and sales is selected and dropped on the canvas, and a bar chart is created. I can apply a custom sort to day of the week so that I get it in the day by day order, starting my week at Monday. Again, resizing my chart to fit the defined template area. To understand when sales occur during the day, a bubble chart is dropped onto the canvas. Sales goes into the size slot. Day of the week goes in the x-axis. And sales hour goes into the y-axis. I can apply a custom sort to both the axes. And I can see from this visualization, much of my sales is concentrated in the morning hours. I might use this insight to help plan staffing levels and periods when specials might be offered to draw in additional business. To understand the relative contribution product groups make, a packed bubble chart is dropped on the canvas. Product group is placed in the bubble slot. Store address in the color slot. And sales in the size slot. I can see right away beverages are the major contributors, and then it looks like food are probably the secondary. Widgets can be used to add text to the dashboard which provide additional information. And as the text widget is dragged and made bigger, the text resizes. I can also drag out shapes if I want additional emphasis. To make it clear the dashboard is focused on April data, I can rename the tab. And to create a new tab, I click the plus sign. The visualizations on this tab will focus on products and who's buying them. So I'm going to rename it to products. To investigate what factors are involved with product purchase, the driver analysis chart is dropped on the canvas. This visualization shows key drivers or predictors for a target based on complex modeling and statistical tests that Cognos Analytics picks based on the data. Quantity is dropped into the target slot. The chart title can be changed by selecting it. and the diagram currently includes all products. To focus attention on almond croissant sales, product is expanded and the almond croissant member is dropped on the filter area. When the chart renders again, I can click the area where it's two or more drivers, and I can see sales day and birth year are predictors of sales. To investigate the impact of birth year, a bar chart is dropped on the canvas. In the generation table, the birth year data group and the birth year are selected and dropped in the bars. Quantity is used and dropped in the length slot. Quantity sorted descending. And I can see young millennials from 1991, 1992, and 1993 are the biggest consumers of the almond croissant. I might use the insight from this graph to create a marketing campaign targeting Gen Xers to buy more croissants. This concludes the video. You've now seen how to create a multi-tab dashboard, how to add visualizations, how to change visualizations, how to apply filters so that you focus attention and limit the data. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.